Breathe to settle in. And just as you give yourself a moment just to kind of be where you are, just reminding yourself as we do come into movement, just to take any variations that you want, you need, move at any pace that you want and you need. And just this practice is your time, it's your own. So just let yourself be where you are. And just take a handful of breaths, whether the breath is moving. Sorry, I'm laughing because my music got a little too quick paced too early. Sorry, I'll switch to something a little bit more chill for a second. I don't know if you ladies at home can hear it, but it jumped right into heavy D in the voice, so that's why. Chilling out for a minute. But for now, just letting yourself, since we are all seated, just let your chin just drop in towards your chest. Just starting to let yourself open up the back of your neck. And you can just let yourself kind of drop chin to shoulder, ear to shoulder, however you want to think about it. And just rock side to side, just nice and easy. And I know personally my neck is a little hanging, my neck is a little stiff today myself. So just, you know, giving yourself some room that if you need to pause in a particular position or even letting yourself kind of bypass a particular position, give yourself the space to do so. And then just the next time you drop your right ear over towards your right shoulder, pause there. Extend out through your left hand if you wish, and you can kind of play with the height of your hand. I'm automatically doing mirror image, sorry. Letting yourself stretch out through the left hand. Give it another breath. And then just nice and easy, just let yourself take your arm, just sweep it up and overhead, just letting yourself get longer through your side waist. Just starting to release along your jaw. And then just nice and easy, you can start to let yourself bring your arm down, just take a gentle twist to the side, just giving yourself a moment just to open it up. And it doesn't matter what direction you go first, we're gonna do both. And then let yourself come through, and then just take a moment and let yourself turn to the other side. So Rose, I'm realizing I am still gonna have to teach mirror image because they're seeing me that way. So you can do whichever. You can do what I'm saying or do whatever you want. And then let yourself come back to the center. Take a moment, take both arms up overhead. Let your palms touch if it's comfortable, but then bend your elbows and drop your thumbs back. And if that means you have to separate your hands, that's fine. But then see if you can squeeze your elbows in towards each other. And think about trying to elongate the elbows up to the ceiling. So just having a chance to start to stretch the tricep without any pressure. We'll do it on the floor later. And then just nice and easy, you can just simply unwind the arms, nothing major. And then if you're in a position that you want to recross your legs the other way or change anything to balance out, go right ahead. And then eventually just let your chin drop in towards your chest. And then just start to let your chin, your ear drop over one shoulder and then the other. So this morning I was laughing at myself because I had a yoga top that I tried to put on and it was so complicated. I gave up on it because I could not figure out how to get it on me. And then the next time you let yourself drop your ear, left ear over towards your left shoulder, just let yourself extend out through your right hand. You're just letting yourself kind of melt in for a moment. And then you can take your arm to sweep it up and over your ear, letting yourself have the space to lengthen out through your side waist. And then when you inhale, come up, just let yourself take a twist, just go in one direction, it doesn't matter which one first. And then come back through the center and just letting yourself turn the other way. And then you can let yourself just come on through the center, sweep your arms up towards the sky. You can let your hands lightly touch and then drop your thumbs back. And then try to squeeze your elbows towards each other. And again, if that means you have to separate your hands, that's totally fine. Give it another breath where you are. And then just nice and easy, you can let yourself draw the arms up, just exhale them all the way down, and then just start to let yourself unwind, just coming forward towards the shape of hands and knees. And take a moment if you want to have that pause to kind of stretch one leg behind you and then the other just to release behind your legs, go right ahead. And then when you feel comfortable, just stacking your shoulders over your wrists, knees under hips, just let yourself start to roll through your spine, just hollowing out the belly, and then dropping the belly, lifting the heart, lifting the tail. And then as you're going back and forth, you can give a little shake out of your head, just letting yourself have a chance to kind of wiggle the hips from side to side too. And then the next time you drop the heart forward, walk your arms out into puppy pose and just let yourself sink the head down towards the mat. Don't worry about trying to get your chest to the floor. I mean, if you can, it's totally fine, but let it be a little bit more of an emphasis of dropping through your upper body so your shoulders can stretch. And then here, just inhale, walk your hands in a little bit, and I'm just gonna move my blocks out of the way. You could do it with your elbows on blocks. Let yourself bend your elbows, just let them come down towards the mat, just like we did in the seat. Let your thumbs drop back. And you can either sit in puppy pose, or you can try to bring your hips back towards your heels in child's pose. And it's just a matter of what feels good for you as far as the depth of the stretch. If you elevate your elbows, it will go more intense, so if your elbows are up on the blocks. And then just nice and easy, let your hands come on down. Sit back towards your heels for a moment, and if you're not comfortable sitting this way, feel free to sit in a different position. Just take your left hand out in front of you with your thumb facing up, and then just let it come up, and then rotate the palm away. You'll notice you kind of have to, and just let it drop down behind you. And then start with the thumb kind of flipping up to the ceiling, and then rotate it back in and bring it down. So you're just taking an internal and an external rotation as you just go back and forth a few times. And just letting yourself kind of find the places where you might want to pause if there is a spot. And then the next time the left arm is behind you, just pause there for a moment. Kind of lift up the chest and tuck the left shoulder back a little bit more. And you can tuck your chin if you'd like to. And then just free the hand up, just let it come back and around. And you can just let it rest on your lap or whatever's comfortable. And then right arm, so start with the thumb facing up. Rotate, 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 tip, rotate around. And then just kind of let it come back up and through. And just letting yourself feel that, you know, kind of in and out action through your shoulders, to your wrists, to your forearms. And really just kind of getting a little bit of, you know, just movement through the joint. Now the next time your right arm comes around, pause there, and just let yourself maybe touch the fingertips down, tuck your shoulder back, and try to lift the chest, and just try to even off your chest. You might notice you're trying to lean towards the right. And then let the left arm just come around, and if it's uncomfortable, let the left hand join the right behind you. And you don't necessarily have to have the fingers touching the floor. If they don't reach, come to your low back. See if you can pop the chest up just a little bit more. And then just let yourself ease forward. You can let the hands come down to the mat. Again, if you need a moment just to straighten out one leg and then the other, we're just gonna take a couple rounds of cat and cow and then go to down dog. So giving yourself the space to unwind your spine a little bit, grounding the spine, and then lengthening. And Amy, I can see that you're having technical difficulties, so if you start to get annoyed, I'm videoing this too, so I'll post it on YouTube later if it's giving you a hard time. And then the next time you let yourself start to come up and back, curl your toes under, and just press up and back, and then now you're facing up. And take a moment in down dog or dolphin if you prefer, just to let yourself shake out the head, have a little wiggle of your hips if you wish, really any movement that feels good for you. And I am excited to say that I finally got an inhaler from my doctor on Wednesday, and I think it's actually helping, so I'm not coughing nearly as much. So from here, let your hands walk back towards your feet and just come on into a forward fold at the back of your mat. And if you'd like to, you might take opposite elbows or just let your hands strike down towards the ground. A little shake out of your head might feel nice. And then just soften your left knee a lot. Let your left hand stay down. Take the right arm, just bring it up to the sky. And then just ease the right hand down. Soften the right knee, take the left arm up to the sky. And then here, just take a forward fold, and if it's comfortable, hook your toes with your fingers, push down with your feet as you pull forward with your upper body, and then just exhale, bend the elbows, just let yourself sink in. Inhale, take a halfway lift, and then just exhale, melt down. You can release the hands from the feet, take your hands to your low back, or you can sweep them out to the side, but just come all the way up to stand. Draw the arms up high to the sky. Take a little slide out over to one side, just stretching out your side waist. And then just come back through the center, excuse me, and shift up and over to the other side. And then just come back into the center, and then just slide. Sorry, your hands down into your heart. I chased myself by saying anything about the coffee. So here, as we start to come into movement together, I think you all know me enough by now to know that truly sincere when I say do whatever you wish, skip anything that doesn't work for you, and if nothing else, just let your practice be fun. Don't worry about what you're physically doing at all. On the inhale, you open the eyes when you're ready. Draw the arms up to the sky. On the exhale, let yourself start to fold in, hands down to your thighs. Just think of it like you're sinking into a little bit of a squat. And then roll your spine up like you're doing cat's breath. Good. Then let your heart pull forward. So think of it just like you're doing cat and cow, but while you're squatting, roll yourself up. The next time you let yourself start to sink in, let your hands come all the way down to the mat and walk your arms forward enough your shins come down. And then walk your hands forward and just come on into puppy pose, just letting yourself sink your chest down towards the mat. Then from here, just roll all the way forward, just come on out towards your belly. Extend the right arm out in line with your right hand and flip the palm to the sky. And then just bend the knee, letting yourself roll the left toes behind you. And just giving yourself a moment to pause, stretching out your right shoulder. And then just come back down towards your belly, nice and slow. Slide the right hand in, the left hand out. Turn the palm to face up, and then just roll it open. And Amy, I am recording this, so if you don't want to deal with whatever's happening with your system now, you can watch it later. And then let yourself come back down towards your belly. Slide your hands in. And then here, just come on into a baby cobra. Just letting yourself lift the heart, wrapping the elbows in. And then just exhale, let yourself sink down. Slide your hands under the shoulders, just work your way up and back. And then just come on into downward facing dog, just lifting the hips, dropping the head. And then from here, just take an inhale, take your right leg, reach it up to the sky. Step your right foot forward, coming to the lunge, lowering your left knee down. And we will be knee down for a moment if you want to cushion your knee at all. Right hand to right hip, just sweep the left arm up and over to circle around. And then let the left hand land, and then let the right arm circle up and over. Then here, just do it one more time on each side. You can go nice and slow. Let it be as stretchy as feels good for you. Good, one last time, hi Maura. And then letting yourself bring your hands down to your low back. Lift the heart, sink the hips, only look up if that feels right. And then when you're ready, you can exhale, let your hands come on down, pull back, and just lengthen your right leg, using blocks or not, whatever feels more. And then just sink back in towards the right knee. So we're just going to bend and straighten it, letting yourself draw back, and then sink in. The next time you draw the right leg long, pause there just for a moment. And if you want to use your hand to give a little extra stretch, even just a chance to kind of flex and open up your toes or your feet, your fruit. I've had a Canadian accent this week for some reason a few times. And then letting yourself sink in towards the right knee. Now here, heel toe the right foot a little bit on the wider side, and just to the best of your ability, try to roll your left hip towards the ground. And it may not move very much. I sometimes would use my hand to kind of help hold the foot in place so I can kind of wiggle back and forth a bit. Give it a breath or two. And then from here, just let the hands come up underneath you. All we're gonna do is down dog, just press the right leg up to the sky. Just give yourself a moment to pause. You can open the hip, whatever feels juicy. And here, just lower both feet. We'll do the other side in a moment. Lower down your shins. Walk your hands up towards your knees. And then just take one hand to your low belly and one hand to your low back. And all you're doing here is feeling for not arching or sitting back. So if it makes you distracted, move your hands. But just leaning back, so you're leaning back in a straight line. Yep, just like that, it's awesome. And you choose how far back you go, because the further you lean back, the more your quads will kick in, but the more you might dislike me tomorrow too. And you can move your hands whenever you want. It's just they're just there so you can kind of feel that you're keeping your tailbone lengthened. So Shiva Ray calls this Dandasana and Ustrasana, which is staff and camel. So it means we're not doing the back bend at the moment, but we will do the back bend at another moment. So give it one more time, leaning back. And we'll do this a few times during the practice, so you can always increase the intensity if you want. Hands come to your low back. And then just a casual camel, just lift the chest to the sky, not too big to start. Good. And then when you're ready to exhale, you can fold forward. You might just take a moment in child's pose or even just leaning your hips to your heels. And then however you want to get there, we're shifting into down dog. So you can roll forward, curl the toes under, and then just lift your hips up nice and high. Anytime you want, shake out the head, give yourself a moment to relax. And then ground into your right foot, take the left leg up to the sky. Set the left foot forward, just coming into the knee down lunge. So pushing your knee if you feel like you need to. Draw the arms up to the sky. Then left hand coming down, let the right arm circle up and over. Right hand can land, then the left. We're just going from side to side, so totally go at your own pace. You don't necessarily have to be at the same timing as me. And then the next time, after this left arm circles through, you're going to bring your hands to your low back. Just to whatever degree is okay, sink the hips, but try to lift the heart. So think of it as you're trying to keep some of that space between your left hip crease and your left thigh. And then you can exhale, let your hands come down towards the leg, pull back and lengthen your left leg. And then just let yourself bend and straighten the left leg a little bit. A little bit, I'm gonna say a little bit. But letting yourself just have some room, kind of starting to feel the hamstring, especially if you've been outside and it's so cold out. Gonna give the muscles a chance to warm up. And then drawing back and letting yourself, kind of give yourself a moment to flex and see if you can sink in. So Rose and I are in an 88 degree room. And you know it's cold when it feels good, but it honestly doesn't even feel hot. Right? And then nice and easy, it was 90 when you walked in. Let yourself bend in towards the knee. You know, you can let your hands come to the inside of your leg. Kind of let your hips sink a little bit. That's what helps you give the room to rock to the outer side of the right hip. And then using the hand if you want to hold your foot in place. Yeah, if there's any other actions you like to add to this, we'll come back here again, but absolutely add your own things in. You can soften your jaw. I usually like to rock the hips a little bit. And then when you're ready to start to come undone, you can slide your hands back down towards the mat. Use whatever you need to kind of gather up the energy to press that left leg up to the side. And then just lower the left foot down to knee to right, lowering down the shins again. And then just walking the hands back so you're standing on the shins. And then just letting yourself lean back. And you can keep the hands at the hips or at the belly if you want. Arms extended just gives you a little more activation through the shoulders. If you want to add kind of reaching one arm back and then the other, that gets a little bit more into the obliques. Arms up overhead just simply makes it harder. So just know that you can choose. And you can always change your mind. That's the beautiful thing. Curling your toes under can help you have a little more to push into if you feel like it's crunching around the knees. And now I hear them crying. And then here, the next time you come on up, let your hands come to your low back. Maybe it's a little bit bigger of a camel, but still kind of holding back a bit. And then this time, as you let yourself sink forward, just pause in that child's pose type shape, but then let your forearms come on down. Now, I like to clasp my hands. You can totally do flat palms too. Walk your feet back so you're coming into a forearm plank. And then just spin your heels over to the right and just give a little lift of your hips. So you should feel your right obliques kick in a bit. And then just let yourself roll your feet up and over towards the left. Little lift of the hips to kind of squeeze the ribs towards the hip bone. And then just come on into the center and think like cat's breath. So just get a little extra coil up of your shoulders. And then just nice and easy, lower your hips, your shins, your thighs down to the mat. Unwind your hands and then either keeping the forearms down or you might elevate them, just lifting into cobra. Really squeezing your legs. So I'm squeezing my legs and my glutes quite a bit. And then easy exhale, sink in, slide your hands under the shoulders. Child's pose, down dog, going through chaturanga, however you want to get there. Just line it up and back. And then here, just take your right leg, reach up to the side. Set the right foot forward to a lunge. This time, maybe keeping the knee lifted, but that's totally up to you. Draw the arms up to the sky. Now, like we did before in the beginning of class, take your hands to lightly touch. Drop your thumbs back. And so stretching your elbows up to the ceiling. And all this can be done with a knee down lunge if you prefer. Now try to keep lengthening the tailbone down, sinking in. So there's a little deeper stretch in the front of that left quad, maybe a lot deeper. Give it a breath where you are. Now here, just let the arms come on up. Take them to your hips for a moment. We're just going to spin the back heel to the floor, so it's warrior one. So if you need to, you kind of pop it up and then drop it down. This is for balance purposes. Then take your right arm up on top of the eagle or forearm to forearm. Now try to pull the elbows away from your chest at first. And then just let yourself bow forward, sink in. And we're just going to pause in the forward fold. So if you want to unwind the hands, you're more than welcome to. And let your head kind of drop in. I tend to keep my head lifted so you can hear me. And then here, just stay low. You can let your arms unwind. If you need a moment just to kind of stretch them forward, let yourself have some space. And then either keeping the back knee off the ground or you're welcome to lower it, start to pull back and lengthen your right leg. You can keep the hands on the inside of your foot if you want to. That gives you a little bit more freedom in the belly of your hamstring. If you want the intensity, frame up the foot. And don't forget about using your blocks or any props you might have at home. Try to lay your head and neck relax a little. Now from here, just start to soften back into the right knee, probably coming up on the ball of the back foot, but you can keep the heel down if you want to. Press into your right hand and just give yourself a little bit of a deeper bringing out of the twist. You can even reach the arm to the sky or towards the back of the room if you feel like you want to. Now here, just exhale, let your hands come down to the mat in front of you, lower down the left shin. Slide your right foot back, so the bottom of your foot's facing the sky. Now you can either keep both hands down, or if you want, reach back with your left hand, and just give a press with the foot to lift your heart. You got it. Give another breath. Now from here, you can release the hands down, curl the left toes under, take down dog, taking that right leg to the sky. If at any time you want to flip your dog, you're more than welcome to, but don't feel any pressure to. And then just come back and around, lower down the shins, walk your hands back up towards your knees, and then just lean back. Yeah, and just giving yourself the space. And again, the further you lean back, the more challenging this might feel in your quads tomorrow. But it is a really good way to strengthen them. Just one more with the leans. You're too young to be that cracky. And then let your hands come to your low back. Lift your heart. And just let yourself kind of come to a point that's comfortable for you. And then when you're ready, inhale up. Don't rush. Let yourself be where you want to be. Now start to walk the arms forward like you're shifting towards child's pose, just to get a moment to pause. And then we're coming out into that forearm plank again. So let yourself just slide forward. Again, clasping the hands, or hands can be flat. Now this time, take the right leg in towards the shape of tree. But the tricky thing is, try to keep the knee lifting. Try not to rock your hips too hard to the left. And notice how your butt tries to help you by lifting up. So try to drop your hips in line with your shoulders. And then try to breathe. And just kind of not fall apart. And then let your right foot come back to meet your left foot. You can rest if you want to, or go right to the other side. So left foot to tree or tree-like shape. Trying to keep the knee lifted, but try to drop the right hip. Good, yes, good. Prop up between the shoulders, another breath. And then you can just bring both feet down to the mat. Lower your hips, your thighs, your bellies down. Either stay in more of that Sphinx variation of Cobra, or if you prefer, slide your hands back. Lifting the heart, but wrap those elbows in. Good. And then sink in. I'm taking a casual transition to down dog, but feel free. You want the push-ups, you're more than welcome to take it. Then lift your left leg up towards the sky. Coil the left knee into the belly, so shifting into the lunge. So at first you're gonna be on the ball of the foot. Draw the arms up high. And then this time, open the arms out more like a goalpost. And then see if you can squeeze the elbows towards each other. Now try to drop the tailbone and sink down just a little bit lower. And you can keep your gaze very neutral. Some people like to look up, but don't be afraid to keep a slight tuck in the chin. It's Jala Dharabandha. It's a little lock of action, the throat lock. Then from here, just let your hands slide to your low back for a moment. Try to squeeze the elbows towards each other, so a little bit deeper lift of the heart. And then when you feel ready, you can let your hands come to your hips. You might need to step up a little bit just to let the right heel come down for the warrior one shape. Arms can fly out. Left arm up on top of the right. Scoop up high. And then forward fold, letting yourself drop in. If you'd rather unwind your hands, you're welcome to. And I'll usually kind of bend and straighten the left knee a little bit. It's giving yourself some room to sink into the hips. At least in the type of practice that I teach, it's not necessarily encouraging you to be still. Some practices do. So letting yourself have that space. And then when you're ready, you can keep the head low if it's okay. Just unwind your hands. And then start to lengthen your left leg. So you can either keep the hands on the inside of your foot or frame up your leg, or you might even go back and forth a little bit. If you need to come down on the back knee or you want to, just go right ahead. I don't know if you can hear it at home at all, but there is a little construction apparently going on in the building at the moment, so. And then from here, just letting yourself have even more space, start to sink into the knee even more. Right hand down, you might want to go up onto the ball of the back foot, and then just twisting. So left hand to your thigh, you can bring it to the sky. You might reach it behind you. You can turn your feet. Again, just letting yourself kind of embrace the exploration within the pose in your own body. And then when you're ready to gather it all up, bring your hands down to the mat. Let yourself take it back down, dog, left leg can float. This might be a chance to flip your dog, or you can just open up the hip. You know, whatever feels right for you. And then one more time for now, I'm going to come back around, lower down the chins, walk your hands back, and then lean back. So this is kind of reminding you how much your legs are part of back bending, because this is what gets you up. This is what gets you up if you were ever doing a drop back, or if you're trying to stand up from camel or stand up from wheel. It's engaging through your legs, and it also helps engage your core nice and steady. One more time, leaning back. And then here again, and you'll notice I haven't even brought my hands lower than my hips, so you can be if you want. But it's okay to stay here, and then lift the heart, squeeze your shoulder blades, slight tuck of the chin rather than just letting your head drop back. And then use your belly to help draw you up, very pretty. And then let your hands come on down. Walk your arms for the forearm plank. Again, interlacing your flat palms, and then just come on into forearm plank. Now here, I'm gonna make this a little bit more challenging. Walk your feet backwards a little bit. Yep. But you have to really work to keep your belly engaged. And if you did that and you're like, Debbie, that's no big deal, welcome back further. Mm-hmm. Think of it like if you were trying to give a dog or a cat a bath and they like spread their legs out to like catch themselves on the basin. And now my feet are just sliding, so it's getting worse without my intention. You can let your feet go back a little further if you'd like. Don't worry, if you end up on your belly, we're heading there anyway. Here's three. Ooh, sliding two. And then one, lower everything down. Nice job. This time, stretch your arms out in front. You probably want to. Come up onto your fingertips. And if you can, just let your head come down to the mat, but try to pop your arms up and off the floor. And then here, you can lift your head when you wish. Walk your hands in a little bit closer, but see how my elbows drop to the side? Wrap them in, and then lift the heart up a little bit higher. Good. And then you can soften it. Walk the hands in a little closer. And anytime you don't want to come closer, you don't have to. Wrap the elbows down. Well, that's the important part. Then lift the heart. Good. Nice, strong legs. Sink in. We're going to walk the hands in one more time if you feel like it's necessary. And then wrap the elbows in. Lift the heart. Use your legs a lot. Excellent. And then let yourself just sink in. However you want to get there, downward facing dog. Just lifting the hips up high to the sky. Readjusting your body on your mat as you need to. Excuse me. Inhale, take your right leg up to the sky. This time, stepping into warrior two. So letting yourself just open it out wide. And now, just let yourself come back, reversing your warrior, and then just coming through side angle. So we're literally just gonna go back and forth a few times here. So just letting yourself go totally at your own pace. If you'd rather get into one of the positions and just stay there, feel free to do so. And then the next time you reach up and back, give yourself a moment just to lengthen out of your side waist as you might deepen the bend in your front knee. And then let your right arm come down. Sweep your left arm up and over your left ear and just let yourself sink in. Now, if you'd rather wrap the arm behind your back or float the right arm, you know, feel free to add in the variations that suit you. But trying to feel the engagement through your belly, the steadiness in the belly at the same time. Now inhale, pull back to warrior two just for a moment. Then exhale your hands down to the mat. Lower down your back shin. Just for a breath, lengthen your right leg just because that'll feel good. And then we're going to be bending the back knee. So let yourself bend into the right knee. You might reach back for the left foot with the right hand and give it a little pull, letting yourself just open the chest to the sky. Now, if you want to come down to your forearm here or anything, you are more than welcome to do it. And don't be afraid to move your hips a little bit. You can slide back and forth. I'm realizing I never did this on the left foot and hands and knees, so I apologize. So it might still feel a little bit tighter. Now from here, just let your upper body come on up and just let your hands just relax down to the floor. Now I think the majority of you have done this with me at some point, and I know more, it might have been a little while for you, but it doesn't matter. Just want you to kind of see what happens. If you can, you come down to your forearms. If that makes you too low to the ground, you can come onto your forearms second, but you start to pull the right knee into your belly and then shift into forearm plank. Yeah, long-legged people, it's more of a challenge. And then your right toes come to the mat, and then just press up to dolphin, lifting the left leg to the sky. This is actually a little Patrick Beach trick. And then pull your left knee into your nose, step a little closer maybe, and then right leg up to the sky. And then it's totally your call. You can just stay here with the leg lifted, or you can lower the leg down, or maybe you take a couple little baby jumps. If you're in a place in your room where you want to move closer to the wall to feel safer, you know, feel free to do so. Give it a couple of breaths. And anytime you want to pause, or you can switch to the other leg, or you can just come to your belly, give yourself that chance to rest too. And then eventually, you'll be lowering the shins down. Careful, because you're not very close to the wall at all. Okay. And then eventually, you'll be downward facing dog. You want to pull your mat a little further forward and just do the next sequence from there. That way, you'll have enough room.
And then all we're going to do from here is start to enjoy the left leg. So lift your left leg up to the sky, and then left foot forward, warrior two. And just take a moment as you start to set it up.
And then check out your alignment. I'm actually using the camera to help you kind of see mine too. Left toes facing forward, knee dialing open. And then just reverse your warrior, climbing up and back. And then coming up and over, side angle. And we're just going to do this a couple more times, totally at your own pace. So any place you want to pause and be still, you can. Maura, you're glowing in the sun. Yay! Inhale, draw yourself up. Back. And then the next time you come to side angle, just pause. And just know this is your own practice, your body. So maybe stay up really high and supported. Maybe you want to drop the right arm behind the back. Left hand can come to the heart. But let yourself have any freedom. You can kind of play around with the arm positions. Just really think about not just engaging your left leg. You can't really help that. Engage through your back leg too. And then inhale, just give yourself a moment in warrior two or even reversing it. And then just exhale, hands down to the mat, come up on the ball of the back foot, and then just lengthen your left leg, just giving yourself a moment to get off the hip. Now as you bend into left knee, let your arms come to the inside of your right foot. You might come down to forearms or stay high, but then reaching back towards your right foot with your left hand. And you can kind of let yourself sink in, you might draw in and out of it. I know for me personally, this particular hamstring is super open, so this particular quadricep is super tight. So letting yourself just kind of have the space of knowing one side might feel very different than the other. Deb, your hair is glowing in the sun too. Look at all the sunny spots. Give it a breath. And then when you're ready, you can just unwind the foot. Just let yourself kind of draw the arms in. You might, again, just take a moment just to pull back and sink in. And then again, if it's too much to try to come down from the forearms to pull the knee into the belly, you can start high, pull the knee in, and then lower. Especially if your legs are longer, that might be challenging. And then toes to the mat, right leg to the sky, pull the right foot in, left leg to the sky. Now, your hips are probably over your shoulders more than you might normally get. So
So just be careful when you take the jumps, because sometimes you get more hang time than you might be anticipating, and it can be scary.
Yeah, and if you don't want to jump, just stay in dolphin or just keep the leg lifted. There you go.
Yes, look forward.
Good. Do another breath where you are. Now come right to forearm plank. Yep. There you go. Nice. And then from here, just take a pause. Let yourself lower all the way down to your belly. Take your right arm out in line with your right shoulder, but this time bend the elbow so it's a little chicken wing, and then press into your left hand, roll open. And this might feel different being in the middle of the practice rather than the beginning or the end. Bring it back around, and then same thing, left side, let yourself bring the left arm out, but a little bend in the elbow, press into the right hand, roll yourself open. And then from here, just let yourself come back down to the belly. Slide your hands under the shoulders to either take a moment in child's pose or down dog or what's kind of restful for you just for a moment. And then from down dog or however it's comfortable for you, and I'm going to face towards you so I can see you, but sideways in the camera. So take your right leg forward and just come on in towards the lunge. Now, this is going to be a little bit different, and that's why I turned sideways. So instead of focusing on sinking into lunge today, you're going to try to keep the hip a little bit more over your knee, at least initially. So take your, and I'm going to do it in a second so I don't screw you up. Wait, no, I'll do it. You don't do it. Right hand to right thigh, take your left arm up. Now turn your left palm to face away like we did in the beginning of class, and then bring it around and either bring it to your low back or, if there's room, bring it back towards your back leg. Yep, and it might be your hamstring. Curl your toes under, you'll be able to reach it. There you go. But now notice how your chest is probably wicked crooked. So pull your right shoulder back. Maybe extend your right arm to the back of the room. Now where the bigger back bend comes in is not by sinking your hips forward, it's by pulling your hips back. So by moving towards your left heel, which can be very disorienting. So just be careful. Then if you'd like, start to think about reaching the right arm to the sky, you could hold on to the ceiling. Use that to help pull up the left arm. Good. And then you can bring your hands down, lengthen the front leg. It'll feel good to have that moment to pause there. Good. Now here, bend in towards your right knee. Let the arms come down to the inside of your leg. And then again, like we did before, maybe roll your left hip down towards the floor. And sometimes it'll go down if you lower your hips closer by moving your left leg back. Some of us can't roll down to the side like this, so please don't stress if it doesn't want to happen. Now, everything else I'm going to say is optional. So, just know that. If you're very close to the ground and you're happy here, let your left arm sneak out from underneath you so you can lay all the way down on your side. Now, you can either hold on to your right foot with your right hand, or traditionally, it's actually your left hand. And then you start to extend the leg up over your right ear. And if you can't hold on to it, just stick the leg in the air. It's totally fine. All right, you ready, Rose? Does that get worse? So here, you can start to move your right hand out of the way, roll towards your belly, and shift into a split. Keep going. No, good way. You can do that way too, but that'll be easier roll. It's not as far to go. There you go. Yeah, nice. Good. Now the ladies at home, okay? Maybe? Now to get up, you can make this casual. You can just slide your right leg back. But if you're feeling a little fried in fire, you gather your hands up underneath you, pick the whole thing up, and swing it back. Down dog. Right leg to the side, bend the knee, open the hip. Flipping might feel spectacular. It's totally up to you though. And then just let yourself come back around. Don't worry about anything fancy in the middle. Let's just step the left foot forward. We'll get even first and then we'll do something else. So, okay, I'm just gonna turn. Actually, I wanna be able to see Rose on the right. So, left leg is forward again, hip is over the knee. So take your right arm up. Turn the right palm and face behind. And don't worry about going for the foot. If being at your back is a good spot, stay right there. I was telling Rose, if you curl the toes under, you might be able to reach the heel more comfortably or use your block. And then here, my chest is super crooked. So you want to try to drop the left shoulder back, which is why the left arm extending helps. You could also bring the hand behind your head if you felt like you wanted to. So this is basically Ardha Ustrasana. It's half camel. Give it another breath. Ooh, it's intense. Draw the left arm up to the sky. You can use it to help pull the right arm up too. And then just let yourself sink forward over your left leg. And that's when you might pause in a lunge for a second, or just go right back into pulling the left leg towards that half split. Now here, sink in towards the lunge, hands onto the inside. Now you can stay here, you don't have to do anything else that I say, but if you want to, coming down to the right arm, this is when I find the left arm underneath the leg is helpful to kind of hold it there. And then if you're pretty close to the ground and you're okay, you can wiggle your arm out so you're laying all the way down. Yep. And then you can do same hand, same leg, but traditionally it's opposite. So it's right hand to left foot. And then extend it up and over. Try the other hand, I bet you can. Yes, you can. See it. Good. There you go. Yeah, use your hand on the ground. You can use your hand on the ground and pull it. That's it. Now here, to come into split, you just have to get your left hand out of the way. Roll yourself down to the belly. So it's a little bit more at an angle. It's not straight out in front of you necessarily. Good. Yeah, and this split might feel more comfortable than normal because we're keeping our chest low. If you want the intensity, you can lift the heart up, but that's going to change it. Give it a couple of breaths. Now when you feel ready, start to gather your hands underneath you. You can just totally slide your left foot back. Or try to pick the whole thing up, bring it up to the sky, open the head. You might flip if you feel that. And then just come back and around. Lower down the shins and just take a second in child's pose. Just letting yourself kind of melt down. So we're going to do one more thing with dolphin, and then one more thing with back bends, and then we'll get to lay down. So at any point, if you'd rather just lay down, welcome to. So Rose, you can walk your mat. Bring it a little closer to the wall, not a ton. So ladies at home, if you want to have something behind you, because we're going to have the dolphin option to kind of play with the scorpion shape, if you want to. And if not, you can just stay with your feet on the ground and bend the leg, open the hip. But so if you want to move near a wall, move a wall. I'm just going to turn so you can see me, so you don't have to necessarily be near a wall to do anything. I'll watch you too in a second. So bring yourself on your mat. You can interlace your hands or not. And this could be done in headstand if you'd rather do headstand also, or handstand too. But letting yourself kind of walk the feet in. Just take one leg up to the sky. And then here, especially if you're nervous, don't try to bring both legs straight up. Take a little hop and just bend to your knees. And letting your legs kind of stay in a stag position. Because in that way too, you can extend your leg. It'll pull you back down rather than make you feel colder. Good. Put your chest in the wall. Yep, even more. Chest. Good. Nice, ladies. And then when you're ready, give yourself a moment to rest and pause. Come down before you get tired. That's what's coming to you. And then when you're ready, try the other side. And I said that's Rose about coming down because I've learned the hard way in some of these poses that if you stay in them too long, your body decides it's done for you and snaps you out of it. So that's not always the most pleasant sensation.
My shoulders will give it.
That happened to me once doing this pose and I thought I was going to run myself. So letting yourself just play a little bit with the forearm stand, scorpion shape, headstand, whatever it is. You have one leg, so it's a little bit more popular for me. Yeah. And don't worry, when you feel done with it, you're welcome to come to a seat. And then eventually we're coming around to a seat. So just letting yourself bring your bum down to the ground. Now we're gonna do something, Mara. We're gonna do something that is a little bit of a kind of a fancy way of getting into a back bend, but it's also just really good to open up your shoulders. So just place your feet on the mat, probably like hips distance or so. My knees are bent, but not like super tight to my chest, a little bit more in front of me. And then just bring your right hand down to the ground. Take your left hand, circle it up, that whole rotation of the wrist, like you're kind of souping a lasso. Yep. And then here, just bring it back around again, kind of rotate it back. Then bring your left hand down, do the right arm up. And then let yourself bring that right hand back and around. Now here's where you can get a little funky, and you can watch first if you want. You can keep your bum on the ground, you push into your feet, lift the hips as you circle. And then you can bring it back. Yeah, that's it. And then switch, circle up, lift the hips. And then come back down. That's it. So it's basically like you're flipping the dog without flipping your dog. Now, depending on your shoulders, I think you'll be able to do this first, that sometimes you can lift high enough to rotate around to get your hands around to come to the heel. But I will say for some of our shoulders, that can be a bit sketchy. So if you'd rather stay with the lasso, yep, all the way around, there it goes, yep, just flip the hand on the ground, perfect. Then if you want to come back down, let your hand on the ground start to rotate towards me the other way. Yep, and then start to flip down the other way. Yep, flip your hand, don't make it stay there. Good. Nice. Sorry, that's super hard to teach to you at home, but I can see Rose here. So from here, try it on that side if you want. From here, you can either keep playing with that, yep, keep going, flip the hand on the ground. If you want to, laying down your back to come to bridge or coming to wheel. So turn up the other hand, turns. Yep, there you go. Awesome. That was the full circle. Nicely done. So coming down for bridge or wheel. And the nice thing is you're super ready for it today. Sometimes we just throw it at the end of class, like it's because it's one of the closing poses. But when you're really prepared for it, this one, wheel or bridge, might feel particularly good. Camel, whatever you want to do, my friend. If you want to do scorpion again. Totally up to you. Yeah. The ladies at home, just basically were watching the comments, so I'm going to stick with this stuff. So, bridge, I'm using my block just because it feels fabulous, but letting yourself be where it feels good. You might even let the legs go long, soften, look forward, push your toes into the mat to pull your chest forward. Mm-hmm. Do you handstand?
No.
Well, then I don't need the handstand in the wall. Do you handstand at all?
I like hand.
Okay, no, that's okay, because you can go, because it's actually easier to open your back and handstand than forearm stand.
Yes.
That's the reason I ask.
Yeah.
Try the way straight up and down.
Like
forearm stand? Yeah, forearm stand. And then here, if you're on the block, or if you're not, bend your knees. Just cross your right ankle over the left thigh, just coming into a figure four. Good. Now make your leg up in the air super strong. Yes. Zip up your belly, don't need back. Good. That's it. Excellent job. Good. It's just like doing a forearm plank, just upside down. Then when you're ready, just pull the knee into your belly and you stand it up to the sky. Beautiful. And then let yourself lower down that leg. And then just take the other side. Pause in between, especially if you don't have a block. You always use a pillow, grab a couch cushion, take a figure four. It's actually fun practicing at home because there's so many more props you can use. And then when you feel ready, pull the left knee into your belly, extend your legs straight up to the sky. So for any of you, if that was frustrating at all, I totally can sympathize or empathize. Let your feet come down. Last week when I went to my silks class, let your legs go long in front of you. Within the first 10 minutes, I got really pissed off at myself because I couldn't do what we were supposed to be doing. And I basically sat on the floor for 45 minutes and pouted. Just because I knew I was going to cry, I had to just let myself stop. I'm not saying that's what you should do, but sometimes you just have to give yourself a break and be like, you know what, today's not the day. And some days it feels awesome, other days you just need to chill. So from here, it's totally your call where it's going to be comfortable for you. So you can keep your hips on the block if you have that and it feels good. Maybe you want to come flat down to the ground. Actually, a twist would probably be a really good choice just because of all the back bending. So if you feel the urge to take a twist in any way you want, you might even be on the block or if you want to come down to the ground. And then just eventually giving yourself a moment just to pause, just to be still. And it doesn't necessarily have to be in a traditional Shavasana shape if that doesn't suit you. If you'd rather lay on your back, if you'd rather come to your belly, if you'd rather go upside down. resting. Just letting yourself take a pause. So you may have heard on the news this morning that Cicely Tyson passed away, and just, you know, a really brave, strong woman who did so much for women, for the Black community, just in general. And this was a quote that my niece posted at one point, and I just really, I liked it a lot, and I thought it was really cool. And my niece is an officer in the Marine Corps, you know, 25, and she's pretty badass herself. But the women who I love and admire for their strength and grace did not get that way because everything worked out. They got that way because things went wrong, and they handled it. And then they handled it in a thousand different ways, on a thousand different days, but they handled it. Those women are superheroes. So just giving yourself a moment, whatever position you're in, maybe giving yourself a moment to reflect on the women or the people in your life who you think of as superheroes, and maybe really give yourself a moment to think about what are those qualities about yourself that make you a superhero, because we all are in different ways. Take a handful of breaths, whether through your nose or through your mouth, and I say it a handful, meaning just deliberate breaths, letting them be full, be deep, and fully let go. When you're ready, if you choose, because if you'd rather stay, especially if you're at home, if you'd rather stay on the ground and just chill, you're more than welcome to. I'll just end the meeting and you can just let it go. But if you want to have that moment of pause together, you can soften your knees, you might roll to one side, eventually easing your way up to a comfortable seat or a seated position, letting your hands just come on in towards the heart, towards the palms. So my new morning ritual is with my dog that after we go for our walk, we get back on the couch and snuggle for a bit. And so I've been watching the Today Show quite a bit. And this morning, Carson Daly was interviewing Michael Phelps and his wife. And if you're not familiar with it, Michael Phelps has a lot of issues with anxiety and depression. And his wife has actually helped work him through that quite a bit. But ultimately, the person who has the anxiety and the depression comes down to that. You know, you can't control that for them, unfortunately. But one of the things he talked about and that he's teaching his kids to do is lion's breath. Some of you may know I have a love-hate relationship with lion's breath because sometimes I feel like so much has to come out, I'm afraid I won't be able to stop. But I liked the version he did, which is a little bit more subtle, and it was just more of a, it wasn't the big roar, which you can roar if you want to roar, you just know who's home with you. But, and Rose, feel free, if you want to roar, you can roar. But just take a nice big inhale and just letting it go. And thank you, ladies. Thank you so much for getting up early. Thank you, Miss Rose, for being here with me in person. Thank you all, y'all at home. And Amy, I hope you enjoy this later when you can get back on. But namaste. You're welcome. Thank you. Nice to see you, Maura. Okay. Bye, Deb. Bye, Beth.